If you've ever inherited old code that you're scared to touch, same here. So let me show you how Claude Code helped me clean up a real issue on my website. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Today, I'm partnering with Anthropic to show you how I fixed a real problem on my website using Claude Code. This isn't a mock example, this is real. I have a custom JavaScript filter plugin on my blog. It works, but it's old, it's slow, and it's impossible to update without help. So my developer, Lucy, and I use Claude Code to analyze the code base, rewrite the filter, and add a new option using the web version of Claude Code, which makes everything easier to follow on screen. You'll see exactly how Claude Code works on real files, how it proposes changes, and how it keeps you in control of every step. Let's get into the demo. First, Claude Code needs context. Instead of pasting files back and forth, it connects directly to GitHub. That's where my plugin lives. When you open Claude in the browser, you'll see Claude Code here on the left-hand menu. This is the workspace that lets you pull code directly from GitHub instead of copying and pasting files yourself. Now, obviously, before you do anything, Claude asks you to connect your GitHub account. This is from the very beginning. So I'll do that now and we'll skip ahead. And we're in. You can adjust your general Claude settings here, but we'll navigate back to Claude Code with GitHub now connected. GitHub is where developers store their code by default, so Claude Code can read the real project without you uploading anything manually, which is so awesome. If you have multiple repositories, or repos for short, you can select the right one from your dropdown. That tells Claude which project you want to work on with this session. And for the environment, we'll leave it on default for this demo, but I could create another if I wanted to. And that is the first step. Now that Claude Code has context, we asked it to analyze the legacy filter and explain how it works. This is where Opus 4.5 shines. In the web editor, we asked Claude, explain how this filter plugin works and where the performance bottlenecks might be. And we choose Opus 4.5, it's set to that. This is most capable for complex work like code. So Claude begins scanning the project. On screen, you'll see it pull in the JavaScript files that it needs and it starts reading through the code. And it's gonna take a second because obviously Opus 4.5 is thinking through a more complex task here, exactly what it's designed for. Claude will then walk through the logic of the filter in clear language, which is especially helpful for someone like me. The response panel breaks everything down into clear summary of bottlenecks. I love, love, love this table format. Claude lists out each issue, the file location, and the impact, like repeated DOM queries, layout thrashing, and multiple timers firing at once. And if we scroll back up, I want to point out something really impressive. Claude immediately recognized this as a filtering plugin built for Squarespace, specifically Squarespace list sections, even though we never told it that. It understood that entirely from the code. Impressive. With the analysis done, it's time for the update. This is the exact prompt Lucy wrote, realistic for how developers actually work. Say hello to Lucy, my developer. Her understanding of this stuff is definitely more advanced than mine, which is why she's here for this part. Claude Code is the tool, though, for someone like me that might not write code, but is comfortable troubleshooting it. But it's also great for someone like Lucy, for developers, for coders. This is why I brought her into the mix. So we drop in the prompt here in the web interface, rewrite this legacy JavaScript filter to improve speed and include a third filter. Keep the core logic, but make it faster and future-proof. Claude Code creates a step-by-step plan first. You'll see the plan appear at the top of the response panel, listing what it's about to change and why before touching any files. That's important. Once it's ready, the rewritten code appears in this green code block. This is the new version of the filter, not the original. It's the updated JavaScript file, and Claude notes that only this file needed rewriting. The CSS did not require any changes. In this case, Claude didn't need to update multiple files. All of the improvements happen inside filter.js, which keeps the rest of the plugin intact. Once the rewrite is complete, Claude shows a summary of what's new. On screen, you'll see a list of the new features it added. Claude also gives you a full outline of the updated code structure. It walks through the main pieces of the plugins. This makes it easy to understand how the updated plugin is organized, even if you didn't write it yourself, like me. And at the bottom, Claude confirms that the changes were pushed to a new branch. This keeps the updated version separate from the original code, so nothing is overwritten. That's the safe way to review and test a new plugin before you publish anything. thing. Now we approve the changes. This is where Claude Code feels like working with a real engineering teammate. I love this. Now let's switch over to GitHub and take a look at the branch Claude created. On screen, you'll see the repo open and that yellow bar at the top is GitHub letting you know that there's a new branch with changes from Claude. In the branch dropdown, you'll see the Claude slash analyze filter plugin. That's the version Claude generated. Right here, we can click compare and pull request. That's the step that you'll take if you're ready to merge Claude's update into your main branch. Developers use pull requests to review the changes before they go live, and Claude even writes the update summary for you. Love that, so you know exactly what was improved. We're not merging anything here, but the view shows how Claude's update fits naturally into a real development workflow. Once the code is updated, we test the page and you'll see the difference immediately. Now for the exciting part, let's get the updated filter running on my site. See here, only 3 filtering options, but we're adding 1 for pricing with our new code. I'll paste it in place of my old here in Squarespace, click save and refresh the page. So not only does my site load faster right away, but we've also got our 4th pricing category option appearing alongside the existing ones. When I click it, the list updates instantly, just like the original filters. All of these changes happen inside the Claude Code web interface, from analysis to the rewrite to the commit. And if you want, this workflow can even run on a schedule, daily, weekly, hourly. Claude can check the repo whenever you choose and keep the plugin updated automatically. So good. This is the real power of Claude Code. You stay in your own workflow, you stay in control, and you solve real issues inside a real code base, even if you're not a developer writing every line of code. You can try Claude Code with the link below. I suggest you do. It is absolutely awesome. Thank you to Anthropic for this partnership. I'm Phil Pallen. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.